takes a lot of energy to run a farm. So where can you find the most affordable energy? Well, the cheapest energy is the energy you don't use. A farm energy audit will pinpoint the areas on your farm where there is the most opportunity for reducing energy costs and improving operational efficiency.
I've never seen a case where there was not significant savings.
In Michigan, from 2010 to 2018, 335 farms performed energy audits. The average savings was $18,000 per year, with an average payback period of 3.7 years.
When you can account by kilowatt hour what your savings will be, it becomes fairly easy to understand how you can improve and your cost benefit.
Once we did that energy audit, then we could start to identify the agencies we could work with to get that funding. We could work with our utility, we could work with Semco Energy, our gas provider. We worked with Michigan State helped us with some rebate dollars. We could get REAP grants to help us put all that together to make these programs work for us.
We had a 55% energy savings by going from 3 soft hose travelers to 2 center pivots that were low pressure versus high pressure.
Energy audits can be completed by the farmer or conducted by a certified farm energy auditor. Some professional auditors work remotely, but a boots-on-the-ground audit will provide a more comprehensive picture. Contact your local extension office to find out what's available in your state. So, how do you prepare for an energy audit?
The auditor will let the farmer know that there's some information that they need to have gathered. That information would include electric bills for the last 3 years in particular. That's a very important part of determining the return on investment.
Other things on the list are the various types of equipment, the different motors that they have, compressors, the types of refrigeration equipment they have. And then we're looking to get a better understanding of their operation. And they know their business, so the preparation is relatively easy.
Our energy audits typically can take an hour to 2 hours.
We're just listening to them, trying to understand what they're doing and what opportunities they see, and then maybe we can address those through the energy audit.
You would think they all do things the same, but they don't.
A really important component of the energy audit is where the farmer and the auditor walk around the farm so they see the same thing. That's really important because there are some audits that farmers are sent where the farmer fills in the information, and that second set of eyes that the auditor brings helps the farmer see things that they wouldn't see because they're around it every day.
We worked with one dairy that was a longtime family operation, and their utilities are sales tax exempt. In this particular situation, they had built a new barn and had put a new meter on that barn. And unbeknownst to them, they were paying sales tax on that meter. And so once we discovered that, they were able to go back 5 years and collect that sales tax that they had been paying.
The average cost for an energy audit is about $1,200. But between utility rebates and the REAP program, and EQIP program for that matter, there is some skin in the game. So they don't get everything paid for, but probably 90%. When an audit is complete and the farmer has it, then the farmer is in a position to make some financial decisions. That audit has a prioritized list of what options a farmer can choose.
A good auditor will base their recommendations on up-to-date technologies.
So staying up to date with improvements, that is a daunting task. An energy auditor attends classes that might be sponsored by a university, might be sponsored by a utility, might be sponsored by a lighting fixture company or something like that, so that they can get the latest, most current information as it relates to agriculture.
In 2009, LED wasn't on the list. It wasn't a viable alternative, but over time, the technology's improved to the point where it is the answer.
We're now looking at things like adding solar panels to the top of turkey barns and just looking at technology that we would not have thought about.
The report will also include a list of other opportunities for funding those recommended practices. And so that could be utility rebates, low interest loans, and grants through USDA. And there also may be some state programs.
And then we could go out and go to those entities and find that money. It became a pretty easy process at that point.
It's not going to hurt you any to understand your energy system. And if you understand your energy systems better, you know where you can improve, even if you never get any of the grants. The benefits themselves over the long term are huge.